Dauda Mohammed is my guest. He played for Kumasi Asante Kotoko in Ghana. And I remember a wonderful goal that he scored against Accra House of Hope. He left from Ghana and went to Anderlecht in Belgium. From Anderlecht, he was loaned out to Vitesse Arnhem, where he had a fantastic performance. He went back to Anderlecht and he's been loaned again. We found out more about all these things. Dauda, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
You are welcome.
Thank you.
Your face is always looking cheerful. What's the secret?
Always you have to always smile to people, you know. It's always good to always look cheerful so that people always welcome you, you know.
Now let's go to Europe before we come back home. When you were leaving for the season, I had a chat with you and you told me when you go, you sit down with Coach Vincent Kompany. Talk to him about your chances of playing for Anderlecht. If you see the chances are slim, you want to go on loan somewhere where you can have, you know, full-time, you know, performance. When you spoke to Kompany, what was the response?
Yeah, when I went there in the beginning, I spoke to him and he said, yeah, now they don't have a lot of strikers, so at the moment he wants me to stay. But during the course of the transfer window, they got to buy a striker, so which means my chances of playing became slim. So I spoke to him again and he said, yeah, if there is a possibility that you can maybe have a loan deal elsewhere where you can get playing time, it will be better. Then I said, okay, yeah. Then I started speaking to my agents and we started working, and at the end of the transfer window I had a team to play.
Now you've gotten a new team. What has been the environment for you after joining a new team?
Yeah, I went there, I think I was there for only 4 days. I went there on Wednesday and we had a talk with the coach, and the coach assured me for here he's going to give me more playing time. So I'm sure I'm definitely going to have more playing time over there. But you know, it's not going to come easy. You have to work for your position, you know. So, but with them, everyone is nice. Everyone looks helpful, you know. Everyone wants to communicate with you, try to be part of the team, you know. So though I'm just a few days over there, but I think, yeah, it's really nice over there.
There are those who argue that regardless of the opposition, even if you are in a team and Cristiano Ronaldo is boss and you play in the same position, you need to stay and fight for your position. Do you share the same opinion with them?
Sometimes it depends on who is taking care of the team, the manager, because if they buy a player on your position and the manager tells you, yeah, for you are not going to play no matter what, definitely you have to leave. Even if you stay there, you play more than even the player who is there, there is no way you're going to play because the manager might not like you. So you have to move on. But if the manager makes it open, like everyone has to fight for his position, then that's where you can say, yeah, I can stay and fight for my position. There is open. So whoever performs really well, he's the one who is going to play. But the situation where a manager tells you are not part of my plans, if you stay, there's no way you're going to play because already he has made it clear.
You went on loan to visit Vitesse Arnhem. You played very fantastic in the Dutch league. People felt that, look, after playing so well for Vitesse, you should have gone back to Vitesse to play for them. Did they make any attempt to get you back, and what was the response?
Yeah, they made an attempt to bring me back. But you know, with my loan over there, it was a loan with option. And you know, the option Anderlecht gave them was too expensive for them. So before the season was about to end, they contacted Anderlecht that, look, now we need a player, but we don't have the money to pay to buy him now. So we want you guys to loan him back to us for another year, after which maybe we can see if we can take the loan. But now we don't have the money to pay for his price now. Then Anderlecht said, no, it's a contract, we had a deal that if you like the player, you have to pay this amount for him. So since you like the player and you don't want to pay, there's no way we can loan the player back to you. So that was the situation. That was why I couldn't go back.
What do you know about the Danish league?
Ever since I heard the news I would be moving there, I started speaking to people who knows a little bit about them. I had a teammate in Anderlecht who came from Danish league. And I spoke to him a little about him, and I also spoke to Coach Didi Dramani, who is also part of the technical staff of Nordjylland. So they told me quite a little about the Danish league. So I think it's a league with a lot of physique and, you know, a lot of tactics. You know, they play with tactics and very compact game. So, but he told me with my qualities, I can perform over there also. Yeah.
Didi Dramani is virtually your father when it comes to football, and having him in Denmark, there you are also going to play. Does it make you feel very comfortable?
Yeah, it makes me feel comfortable because mostly, even when I was in Belgium or when I went to Holland, he always calls me to, you know, advise me about every game. You know, how I have to approach the game, how I have to take the game. So it's now I'm closer to him, so it will be much more easier for communication, and he's always there for me. He told me he's always there, so if anything I can contact him, I can call him and ask him, he's there to help.
How do you compare it to where you previously played? You played in Holland, you played in Belgium, but when you compare it to the games that you've watched in Denmark so far, how do you see yourself fitting in there?
You know, every country has its style of football, you know, his style of playing. You know, in Belgium league, they play with a lot of defensive work. You know, you have to work defensively. But in Holland, it's open play. They like to play football. They like to keep possession. But in Denmark, you know, they also play with physique. You know, very compact in defense, a lot of energy, a lot of physique. So, like I just went there. So maybe with time, I will get used to their system, and maybe hopefully I will integrate well in the team, and maybe I'll start delivering.
You played for Kumasi Asantekotoko before traveling outside the country. I remember speaking to you on the performance of Kotoko during the Confederation Cup, and you said emphatically that they should try to keep Coach Siki Akono. They ended up sacking him. When you heard the news, were you disappointed?
Yeah, I was a little bit disappointed because I was watching their Confederation Cup last season, and the way Kotoko was playing, I really liked the way they were playing, because about quite some few years ago, Kotoko cannot even keep the ball for up to a minute or two. But now in last season, you could see the players passing, moving, doing a lot of movement, keeping the ball, even winning in some away games. You know, it was quite impressive. So I thought maybe the management could have kept Siki Akono to, you know, build up on last season's performance, and maybe hopefully this season could have been better. But you know, the management knows what they are doing. They are taking care of the club. They are directing the club. So they think maybe it's the right decision to sack him. So maybe, I don't know the kind of decision that made them sack Siki Akono, but you know, it's...
But do you still have that heart that you had for Kotoko? Do you still have it?
Of course, I still have the heart for Kotoko.
Because Kotoko, when heart comes, you play for us.
I still have the heart for Kotoko. You know, I always say to my friends, I still have some years to play for Kotoko again, because I feel like I didn't finish what I started over there. But you know, sometimes you need to change your environment. That's why I left. So maybe in the near future, maybe I'll still come back to Kotoko.
If you are just connecting, this is FMIG TV. My name is Sheikh Tofik Sino, and with me is former Asante Kotoko striker, Dauda Mohammed. Dauda, you've gone through a lot of hands before becoming the player you are today. Specifically, Mr. Keto Krepu is somebody who is very key to events in your career. How important a personality is he to you as Dauda Mohammed?
Ket has been a father to me, you know, from the time I was about to leave Ghana. He has been always there advising me, you know, sometimes pay us a visit in Belgium, you know, try to let us feel at home, like feel like we are like a family. You know, he's always there in good moments, in bad moments. He's always there to support. He does everything humanly possible to make me feel happy, to make me feel as a better player to play. I just have to concentrate on football. Any other thing outside football, he will take care of. So with Kurt, it's like I have everything.